Hi, welcome to Lori Krein's Art Studio. Today, I'm very excited. We have a very special guest on the show today, and I want to introduce you to Frankie.
Hi.
It's good to see you.
It's good to see you too, Lori.
Thank you for being on the show today. Frankie has been making these dolls out of muslin and, well, she'll explain it to you in a couple minutes when we get started, but they're really cute, and when I saw them, I thought she's got to come on the show and show everybody else how to make them because they're just really, really cool. And kids can make them, and so we'll get started on that in a second. I just wanted to, first of all, do our eco-friendly tip of the day, and Frankie contributed this, and why don't you tell the folks what your eco-friendly tip of the day is?
Turn off your, or unplug your cell phone chargers. They suck power when you're not using them.
There you go. So just remember to do that, and if we all do it, then it will make a big difference and maybe make a little bit of an impact on the amount of power that we're using. So that's a great tip, thank you. And the other information I wanted to let you know and remind you to visit my website, which is lorikreinstudios.com, and you can find information there about the project that we do today, as well as other upcoming events and classes that you can sign up for. So, and also I always encourage you to send in your comments about the show or ideas that you might have that we could put on the show. And if you decide to create any of the projects that we do on the show, then please send pictures and let us know how it went for you. That would be really great. So I think that's all we need to do to get started. These are the dolls that Frankie has made so far, and why don't you tell me about one of the dolls, Frankie?
Well, this is one of the first dolls that I made, and as you can see, I kind of gave it this eerie sort of look to it, made the stitches plain, painfully obvious. A lot of the dolls that I make have a very, very special character to them, each one representing something different. This one I like to call the Huggy Doll.
May I?
Yes.
Go ahead.
And it actually was probably the second doll I made. I had a lot of fun making that one. I get a lot of comments on this one, especially if you get a really nice cloth, or not a super nice cloth, but a cloth that is durable. You can take them out. This one's lasted me a really long time, probably about 6 or 7 months. I have not had to fix it yet. A
Wow.
lot of the times, if you get more of a very unstable cloth, you'll have to fix it maybe every couple months, only because maybe the stitches will break or the cloth will start to peel apart. But I chose a really nice cloth, and I guess it's been keeping up for 6 months now, which is really nice.
That's great. Now, I just want to make sure that everybody can see that this is a Huggy because, can I take this out? So she made this separate little cloth that comes out from the doll. Just hold that right there, because in case Jason wants to focus on that. And so she just made this little extra hanky or blanket or whatever you want to call it, and embroidered a couple of little designs on there with
Just
a
as like an
button.
experiment, you can always just try, and with cloth like this, it's actually a pretty cheap.
What
Or
is
you can,
this cloth called?
I don't actually
You
know.
know, I
You
think
can
it's.
always, I always just pick out cloths from the bargain area of the store, or I have a lot of cloths at home that maybe you been cutting off from t-shirts or shorts even that you've
Great.
made. Any extra cloths are really good for that.
So these are very eco-friendly because although you can buy the cloth at the store, you also could use scraps. Here, you can fix that up. That leftover from other projects, or you can even buy scraps at the thrift store, from leftover clothing or
This is a
whatever.
great example. I actually, when I fixed this one up, because one of the cloths was not very good, but I have, if you can tell, there are different colors on this. These are three
Oh
different
yeah.
types of cloths
I
that I've
see that.
used.
Right. So you don't have to use all the same one. You can use different ones, mix and match.
And it gives it a lot of character. It allows the doll to basically, I was thinking actually of completely covering this doll with patches. It is the zombie doll, of course. So
Of course. That is very cute. I love this. And they're very soft, and they're stuffed. What are they stuffed with?
Just any
Just
sort of
any kind
stuffing.
of stuffing. And you can even stuff them with leftover material as well, I imagine. You
of
know?
Course. Yeah. I've done that before. Sometimes I stuff them with rice if I want them to have a little more weight to them.
Oh, very cool.
Beans are also really good for that. Preferably, though, if you're going to do something small like this, which is what we'll be making later, you do want to stuff it with something small, either like just a cotton or something, or rice, but not usually anything bigger than that, because you don't want it to have like a bumpy texture. You really kind of want it smooth, unless that's what you're going for.
Right, that's true. And it's very soft and cuddly, by the way. So, and I just wanted to ask you, how did you kind of come up with this idea? Like,
you know,
how did this start?
That's a really good question.
I'm not sure.
I've actually been meaning to make a doll for a couple of years now, and one day I just decided to make this, and it's just a lot of what I watch on TV, some things that my friends give me. For example, the two different size buttons wasn't originally my idea. It was one of my friends, and I had showed him the sketch I had for the doll, and he was like, "Are you gonna have two different size buttons?" I was like, "Huh.
Sure, why not?"
Yeah.
Excellent. So
usually I do have two different size buttons.
That gives them that more lovable feel, I think, too,
and
for me.
What's really good about making so many dolls is you really do get to like practice your embroidery and kind of give it that sort of just weirdness to
it.
Yeah. I guess you could put it. Yeah.
Well, it's more like a personal touch too, you know?
It really is.
That some people might make smaller stitches or bigger stitches, or and you could just, like you said, make any kind of face.
And you can really, it's really fun because you can go out there. I like to get an unusual size string for my sewing, more like embroidery string than a normal thread, because I like my string to be really durable. And then you can also just get white and then color it too. You can dye your strings different colors. If you can't find green, you could always take white and dye it red or green or blue.
And what have you used? Have you done that?
I have done it before. Today I'm just going to use store-bought red.
Right.
But it actually looks really cool, and you can give it a tie-dye effect, and that way when you're embroidering or putting the faces on or sewing in general, it gives it a nice color.
Wow, that's really cool. I've never tried to do that, so that's a great idea. Let's just get started with showing our friends at home how to make the doll. So first of all, let's go over the materials that they'll need to get together.
So you're gonna need an embroidery. If depending on the thread you're using, you want to choose your needle. I like to use this sort of thick string, so I choose an embroidery needle. The great thing about this is that you can do this with kids, and not really have to worry about how sharp it is. Because if you can see, I can.
Oh, that's fine.
I can actually poke my finger, and it doesn't hurt very much.
Oh, nice. So it's not a real sharp needle.
No.
But it still goes through.
It's still a needle, so you still want to watch out. You're going to need some buttons, and of course, some cloth that you can find or use. But that's pretty much it.
And you need a good pair of scissors.
You definitely need a good pair of scissors. This is not the best pair of scissors. There are probably better scissors out there. But just as long as the tip is sharp enough to cut, then it will be fine.
Okay. And also, I would like to remind everyone that when you use scissors for cutting paper, it dulls the scissors so that when you try to use it on cloth, it might not cut it as well. So I always suggest that you have a designated pair of scissors if you're going to be cutting cloth that you just use for cloth. And then you have other scissors that you just use for paper, because otherwise you might. And that's a rumor that I heard. I haven't had that verified, but MythBusters, let's call them. So we have all of our materials, and then of course you need a plan, or you got to use your imagination for that part of it, of kind of maybe what you want to do or not.
I actually, you really do a lot of experimenting. I've gotten it to a point where I really know how the dolls' bodies work, but with a lot of them, you really kind of want. Like this, a somewhat of a symmetry. So the body and the head are really the same size. There's very little difference. But when it comes to length, that's different. You really want the body to be at least a little bit longer than the head. That way you can really distinguish the two, or else you'll get mixed up, and then your head's going to be the body and your body's going to be the head.
Well, that would be just a horrible. So, all right, so we've got all our materials. We have the cloth, the scissors, the thread, the needle, and the buttons. Yes. So let's bring this over here. And
Stuffing.
Oh, yes, stuffing, of course. All right, so tell me what you've done on the cloth, because there's, I think you can probably see it, but there's writing on the cloth. I want Frankie to tell us what she's got
on there. I've drawn out the basic plan. I've got four squares, two arm squares, and one head square and one body square. Now, here's the thing, is that you don't really need to actually draw it out. You can, if you know how big you want your piece, you can just cut it out. Usually that's what I do, but I thought because this would be easier to explain.
Good idea. Now, you said this was the body,
mm-hmm.
and then this is the head?
Yes.
Okay, so the body is a little bit bigger, and does this include the legs?
Yes, this does include, if you've noticed, my leg, most of the only one that I did the legs are separated is the zombie doll, because it's so big,
mm-hmm.
or else it would have just been a giant pillow. But most of them actually don't have disconnected legs. The legs are connected, and it makes it a lot easier. Because legs are really hard to do sometimes. Those were really hard for me to do at one point.
Okay, I got it. So this is the body and the legs together. It's this one mm-hmm. square, and then this is the head. So now when you do this here, you just have one sheet, but when you do this at home, you should probably have two sheets together so that...
If you want...
Because you need the front and the back?
Actually, you know what I do is I take it and I fold it over and sew it that way. It's lot easier to sew because... Here,
I'm going to start cutting this out. Is that okay?
One seam.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead. Keep talking.
On most of these, I'll only have one seam for the body. Like this one, I have it on the back, and it's just one sheet. If you want to do two and have two seams, that's fine. I like to do these. I have a very small concentration, so I usually like to do these as fast as I can, and I figured out that this is the easiest way that I've really gotten to be able to do. Although when you do start to make smaller, even smaller than we're going to make today, you do really want to do two. Because that's when it gets harder to kind of use one.
Okay.
But, so this is what we are going to make.
Okay, got it.
Which is, I like to call this the little coffee doll. Because if you have noticed, I've got this coffee cup here it's been sitting in, and it's just perfect to fit in there.
I love that. It's like his little bed.
Pretty much. And you know, it's really great because after you've made your doll, you can always just make things for it.
Like what?
Well, if any of you can see, I actually made this bed out of popsicle sticks.
So let's put this on the table. So let's see if Jason can get a shot of that. Go ahead. So you made it out of popsicle sticks.
Yeah, and it's... out of just hot with a hot glue gun, and it's really fun. You can experiment. I actually have a table and chair at home that I made for this doll. And so they really can come with their own characters and just have their own little lifestyle.
So I'm gonna so you have here, this is the doll, and then you have the bed. So you made this little bed to go, or mattress to go in the bed. This is so cute, and it looks really comfy. And so let's look at the bed for a second. So this is made out of popsicle sticks.
And I just used a hot glue gun.
Just popsicle sticks. There's nothing else on here. And that is, you just kind of made up the design.
Mm-hmm. You can really base it off real furniture too.
Uh huh.
And you do need a
kit. That is so cute.
And it's really easy. To be honest, I mean, it might have taken me half an hour.
Wow, that's great. Okay, let's put this back here so we have room to work. But that is so cute. So you can make a house, you can make chairs, mm-hmm. tables.
You can make a lot of things for them, and they just go perfectly. Especially with, I've found that popsicle sticks look really well with them.
Yeah, exactly, because they're sort of natural looking,
mm-hmm.
and the dolls
are simple.
Right, simple, and that's okay. So I've been cutting these scissors, or not the best scissors,
no.
but I've got the three, and this is the scrap, so I'll put this over here.
Why don't I start sewing this together?
So the next step, so after we cut out our squares, and what's the next?
So we're going to take this piece, our body piece,
the
and
body.
We're going to fold it in half. And what you want to do is you want to...
Fold it in half long ways.
Long ways.
Okay,
You want to fold it in half, what do they call it, hamburger style?
Sure.
I think that's what they call it. You want to, actually, oh yeah, that's right. So you want to keep the lines on the outside because we're going to fold it inside out later. But, so you really do want to start in your corner over here, up top, so that you can sort of curve down and make give it that this little shape here of roundness, I guess is what they would call it, for the legs.
That's for the legs. Okay, so you're sewing the corner that you folded. Mm-hmm. This is where you start. Okay.
And usually I don't use colored strings for it. Oops. This part, I usually prefer...
Can you do it out here? A little, yeah,
I usually prefer a white string, but because I think this will probably be easier to see.
Yeah, no, that's great.
But yeah, you knot the end of your string. Just start sewing. And you don't need a super complicated stitch either. If you want to do like a super complicated stitch, if you maybe are stuffing it with something smaller than rice, if you're stuffing it with sand... I suggest then, yeah, you probably should do a very complicated stitch because sand's really hard to keep in there. But
So you're just kind of doing just looping it up and down, up and down. You're doing a very basic stitch.
Very basic stitch. It doesn't, and the thing is that this stitch, as basic as it is really strong and really useful.
Great.
And you can really do this. And it's really easy too, and you can get this done really fast. And like I was saying, it's great for kids to do. Some of the kids at my school would do it during recess with me.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And so that's really fun.
All right, good. So you're going around. So now you're actually coming back up the side of the leg. So if this is the doll that you're doing on the inside. So you started kind of here, and now you're going down.
Yeah, you really want to get it curving again as soon as, probably around this area is where you want to start it to curve it back up here.
So you're doing along the bottom.
Yeah, okay. You do the bottom first.
Okay.
Because what's going to happen is when you do the head, you're going to sew it together.
I see.
There, but you stuff it then too because you want to keep the stuffing in there. You don't want it spilling out everywhere.
Right. Okay, so when this is the doll, so this is where the fold is on this side.
Yes.
And then the seam is on this side, and it's along the bottom. So that's what she's sewing now is she's going along the bottom and then will be coming up the side here and doing this side. So that's, and then eventually she'll sew in between the legs to make it.
That's the last thing I usually like to do. Uh-huh. It gives it a little bit more poof. Because when you actually sew it before, you can. Sometimes I'll do that. It depends on the size of the doll, though. If it's bigger, you can sew first and then stuff it. But when it's smaller like this, mm-hmm. it's really hard to stuff in between those legs because it does get kind of small.
Yeah. I imagine. I love the little ones. It's adorable. It's just so cute. I love it.
I didn't bring any with me today, but I've made smaller ones than that.
Really?
I like to call them little pocket dolls.
Yeah.
Because you really can keep them in your pocket. And you don't even have to put buttons on. You can just draw on faces.
Right. Or you can use string or thread like you did on the other ones mm-hmm. with the little eyes. They're so cute. All right. So you continue sewing. And do you have one that's... Well, actually, you can keep finishing that one up. I think we have about 10 more minutes left. So you're going good. And I just want to show the audience again. This one is so simple. It's basically a square.
It really is.
It's like a pillowcase, right? I mean, that's the shape.
Yeah.
And then she just embroidered the eyes.
It's my stuffing bag. It keeps all of my
It's
over the summer I used to make dolls on the run. And you'd say, and I would actually just go and kind of sit out in front of coffee shops, get a drink, and just kind of sew. And then once I was done, instead of carrying around big bags of cotton, I made something actually to carry my cotton in.
That matches the dolls. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Can I open this for a second?
For sure.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
So I just want to show. So
and
this is
really
just
a nice.
And you
can really pack a lot in there too.
Yeah, I bet. And we'll just take a little bit of stuffing out. I just want to see. Okay, so it's just basic. Basic batting stuffing
pretty
that you
much.
Would use, yeah. In this case, and again, you can just shred material or cut material up into small pieces and use that as your stuffing as well if you want to be a little bit eco-friendly with this project. And but this works as this as well too. Old pillows, you can take the batting out of old pillows too if you're going to throw the pillow away and keep that and reuse that for the dolls.
That's probably the best thing to do with experience with stuffing with cloth. You really. This one was actually partially stuffed with cloth. If you can tell, it's got a flatter underside.
Yeah, uh-huh.
the thing is that I wanted that flatter underside, but if you don't want it to be super, like, super textury and you want it to be smooth and soft, you really do have to kind of cut up the your stuffing if you're going to use extra okay. cloth.
So, all right, so now you've, do you have one that you said you've already done the sewing for?
Yes, I've done the sewing for, or somewhat of the sewing. I can finish the sewing off for these arms here.
Okay.
And finish the sewing for this head. The head is the basic same concept for the body, which is just, I like to leave a little bit of extra string just in case you want to go back and attach it. Mm-hmm. But,
So these are the arm. This is an arm, and this is an arm.
Those are arms in working process.
Okay. So you've got the body, and now this is the head.
And everything's really done the same way. You kind of just fold it over, start sewing it together, and you do it. You would fold it like this too, just like you folded the body.
Okay.
So that it kind of gives it that fattiness, because you really once you start stuffing it, that's gonna start to disappear. It's gonna get a lot smaller. Mm-hmm.
All right, so you're, the next thing, after you finish sewing the pieces together, then, I mean, individually, then you start, is the next step to sew them together?
Yes.
Cool.
So hold on here.
Okay, she's threading her needle, which is a task in itself. I can't see the eye of that needle. I have to use
That's what I love about
a little threader.
I used to do that, and then I got these embroidery needles, and easy. I didn't even have, usually I'll lick it, because that's the trick that I learned from my mom when I started sewing, is to lick it to get the thread through. A good trick is actually at farmer's market. Uh-huh. Beekeepers will sell just bricks of wax.
Oh, and they put that on the end of the
Yeah, or at a, any sort of craft store, they should have wax for you. But wax is a really good thing to use to really get your thread kind of stiff to get it through the hole in the needle.
Well, I never heard that one. There's a good tip for you. Use wax to get that thread nice and tight so you can get it through the needle.
Or that's, even just like, great. You don't even need beeswax. You can use candle's wax too. And just kind of take a little chunk of that candle wax and just go.
Very cool.
And see if it will work that way. Usually you want it a little bit warm, though, if you're going to use candle's wax, because you really need it to stick to the string, which I think is why they use beeswax, actually.
See, I never knew that. I'm used to sewing on a sewing machine. I haven't done a lot of hand sewing except for when I sew on patches onto a pair of jeans or something. So I've never tried to make a doll, but after I've seen this, I have a lot of scrap fabric at home, and I would love to try and make some of these dolls. They're just adorable.
And you know what? You can do whatever, like anything with them.
Yeah.
You can make cute little pillows with faces.
Yeah, I can just see having a whole collection.
I'm actually working on a project right now. It's called the zipper doll, and it's a purse. That's just it's the mouth of the doll is the inside of the purse, and it's pretty cool.
Oh, wow. Well, we'll have to have you on again so you can show us how that turns out.
Yeah.
So we have about 5 minutes.
Okay.
So we're going to just show you how to put the doll together, and then at the last few steps would be, I guess, we have 4 minutes left, to put the eyes in. So what are you doing now?
I'm turning the body inside out, because you want it to look clean. So here we go.
So the stitching, what's cool about it is even though she's turning it inside out to make it look clean, you can still see the stitching, which I think gives it a lot more, you know, character to the dolls.
That's actually, a lot of people say that. I've gotten a bunch of comments about how the stitches really give it, like, it's
kind of like a
eerie, creepy.
Yeah, but
cuteness.
I see it as more old-fashioned and kind of homemade and cuddly and soft, you know, that that like my grandma, you know, might have made it for me. So I think that's
And you can really do a lot with these. I mean, you could get all sorts of stuff from the craft store, even stuff you just find at home and just sew them on.
Well, we try to emphasize eco-friendly projects on this show, so that's the way that I would suggest. So now you're stuffing
I'm stuffing the body.
The body.
Just start out with a little bit of stuffing to kind of see where its shape is going. And then you would just keep adding more and more as you go. You know, and what's really cool about these is you can give them, each one is its own. Mm-hmm. And you really can take your own sort of things from your house and make it. I have actually little warriors at home that I've used a wire skeleton for.
Oh, okay.
And it's holding a drill piece. And so I have a lot of fun with
that. Is that the arm? Is that the sword or whatever?
Yeah.
Okay.
So with the arm, here's what I like to do most of the time is that while you still have your thread connected, I like to turn it inside out already so that once you stuffed it, you can immediately sew it on.
Oh, okay.
To sort of make it easier because then you don't have to.
And they're so small.
They really are. And you know what? I did not bring a pencil, but a lot of the times I'll take my pinky or a pencil and kind of push it. That one's not done being sewn yet.
Yeah, I know. But I wanted to do something. Because I want to have fun. This looks like fun. I want to help.
It really is. And like, it's, my friends are love to hand sew. They say it's really relaxing and really tranquil.
All right, cool. So so we're not going to have time to finish the doll, but you stuff it,
mm-hmm.
and then after you have all the pieces stuffed.
Then you really just, you kind of take this part and you just stitch it on like that, and it's actually not that hard.
So you're stitching the head to the body. That's the next step.
Stitch the head to the body.
And after you stuff it, okay.
And then you, while you're stitching it, you leave a little hole in the back and kind of fill in what maybe you've missed.
Okay.
Stitch that back up, then stitch on the arms there.
Okay.
Just so that you can, it's really easy, maybe a couple stitches.
Okay.
And then just figure out a way to keep it at home.
And then you don't want to forget the eyes. You want to,
oh, yes.
You want to sew the button. When
so
do you do that?
So there's two ways you can do it. Sometimes what I'll do, especially with a headless thing, I'll just, after I'm done doing everything, I'll stitch it through the back and then have it just come out the front.
Okay.
Or before you've stitched on the head, before you've stuffed it, you can stitch on the eyes then, or the buttons. Sorry.
Good to know. That's okay. No, that's great to know. Well, we're just about out of time. So wow, it went really fast. So well, I want to thank you for being on the show today. These are really fun. I love this project, and I hope you'll come back again and show us another project that you're working on.
I would love to.
Yeah?
Yes.
All right, good. Well, I hope that you guys all give this a try, and I want to thank you for joining us today on Lori Krein's Art Studio, and I hope you'll visit the website and get more information. So thanks for joining us. Have a good day.